Hello everybody, welcome to our new session. Today we are going to discuss about a feature file with a table. So in feature file with a table, we can have different type of table we can pass it. So let's first understand what is the advantage of passing a table. So there might be scenarios comes into your feature files or your test automation scenarios where you need to pass set of data to fill the form, and that data is fixed for all the number of scenarios. When I say all number of scenarios, means for this scenario this set of data is fixed, okay? So you need to fill some forms, but when the data are dynamics, you pass it from the examples, but you need to pass the last set of data, so you can pass it at the step level. So at particular step you are passing this last set of data, not at a like examples, like for this exam name you are passing name, for value you are passing value, for status you are passing one. That is at the step level. Here at one step you are passing the same data. Now when you create a scenario outline with the set of table along with example, what will happen? This set of data will pass again and again with this step. User enters self detail as, because this self enter details are almost fixed for different scenarios. Okay, now these tables can be passed in different format. Okay, one is the list of list, means one list of data you're passing, like zeroth row, like a table. How do you see in a data table? Set of columns are there, it is keep on going like this horizontally, okay, and you can see it, verticals are the columns, okay, vertically are the columns, and horizontally your data are increasing like this, it is going. I have given just four set of data, you can pass as many as you want, as many as row, as many as column. So this will be in the form of table. That how we read it, it is like list of list. It's up to you how you convert this data. Okay, next is passing data in the form of map, like this is a key, this is a value. So username admin, password password, email email, like that you can pass as many as you want it. It can be 10 20 100, doesn't matter, but only it is applicable at this data will be available at this step only. But if you need the same data at another step also, you can create some getters and setters and save it for next step. That is very easy, you can do it. Now let's see how these data are getting passed into a particular steps. So we are going to run the table one, and I'll show you the steps definition which I have written for table one. Now how I'm reading the data in the form of table, data table, you can see it, data table. So table dot raw, the way I'm passing, same you just return me raw, means in the raw format, the way I'm passing from the step. And then get one, when I say get one, row one, when I say row one, it means this row, sorry, this row, this is row zero. Okay, so from data table what you get it, from the row one you start it basically. So this is a row one, this is a row two. Okay, so let's go into the here. So you can say row one, row two, zero. I have not given, zeros are basically headers. Okay, column name, you can imagine it's a column name. So what I have done, row dot get one means first row, first data. When I say first row, first data means name, second row first data, column. Similar way I can write it multiple. So I can just, for example, I want to read all the data of the column, you can put an iterator also. You can put a iterators, like how many columns, like the moment you say first row get zero dot how many size of the list, you can get it and you can print it. So I can just pass it like one. So second name will also come like that, similar way here. If I give it, Second data will come for the first row, second row. Okay, so let's run it to understand how it is printing. So you can see it. Neeraj Gupta Prakash Gmail. You can see it. Okay, first row, first data, you are getting it. So it means you are getting this data, Neeraj Prakash. Okay, 0, 1, 2. You can see what I have passed it. 2, 2 means email will come. You can see email. For the second row, email and name is coming. For the first row, name and surname is coming. Now, if you go into this type, like it's a map, like key and value. So it is, it's not like a index one. It is like you have to pass a key, you'll get the value. Now, if I run for the table two, like table one, and if you see here how I'm reading the data basically here, like map of string and table. Okay, so map of string, I'm getting it. So table dot get with a key, I'm getting the username. Table dot get password. As many as the continuous, it will go like email, XYZ, whatever you want, you can get it. Okay, so there's three options are there, four options basically. List of your type, you can create your own type, and also you can read the data. List of list, the first one I showed you, which is data table. List of map with a key and value, that also is possible. Okay, then map, which is an example I'm showing you. So let's run it and see how the data are printing. It is one, sorry, table one. So let me run. So if I large, you can see it, admin first name, password is a second, like a password is password. So if I go into the feature file, you can see it, username, admin, password, password, same I am given as a key, username and password, same I'm getting it, username and password, username, this is a password. So this way you can pass that table. It has very good advantages. Basically, when you have some set of data to fill the forms and all, you can use this table, and that would be keep on passing the same data for multiple scenarios by putting the examples here. As you can see it, I can put the examples and I can pass the more data again. Like this, I can pass it. I can pass the data with this same set of data. I can pass it like this also. So doesn't matter, only same set of data will pass to two type of execution. When I do two types of execution, it will pass. Why it is showing error? Because the scenario, to make it scenario out line, then it will not show the error. Thanks for watching this video.